My name's Peter Jackson. I'm a landscape architect and live and work in Milton. I have the pleasure of displaying some of my photographs in the Crane Library for the month of December. And I enjoy this opportunity to kind of share with you a little bit of what my photos are all about. Part of the reason I became a landscape architect is because of my interest in landscape, in nature, and environmental issues. And I started in high school taking photographs just as I was out hiking and enjoying nature and things like that. And as I spent more time and delved into the love of nature and the love of beauty in nature, it helped me appreciate the landscape, and I wanted to find some kind of profession or a career that I could combine my love of nature and my love of beauty and with kind of a social purpose too, and that's why I design almost exclusively parks and open space. I first began photographing in high school back in the late 1960s, and I did that because I would do a lot of hiking in the White Mountains or wherever I could find, and I would take my camera to accompany me, mostly to document my trips, but more and more so I got to look at details in nature and different views and saw the camera as a means of creative expression and not just a documentation. I think contrast in textures gives a lot of character to photographs. Subject matter is important, but the play of color, light, and texture all together create an image, I believe. One of my favorite things to do with photographs is look at reflections, and whether it's on water or glass, it makes the image, I feel, much more complicated, and I think it's kind of fun when a viewer looks at the image and not just view it and say that that's nice and move on, but you have to kind of look at and figure out layers, and the reflections provide layers to an image. One of the ways that I like to use reflection is to create complexity and have a viewer have to delve more deeply into the image to understand what they're seeing. One image that will be in the show, in fact it'll be a rather large image, I call it autumn reflection, and it's in the autumn, taken in the Blue Hills, and what it shows is the reflection of autumn leaves in water. But what makes this image particularly abstract and interesting is you see it's a shallow pond, so you see leaves that are on the bottom of the pond, you see leaves floating on the surface of the pond, you see the reflections of leaf color, and then way in the background you just see a little sliver of the shoreline and an actual direct picture of the color. And it's a very abstract composition, and you have to spend time to figure out the layers of the image. I do a lot of my photography in the early morning. One, I get up earlier than anybody else, and it's when I've got time to myself. And also because the light, and as the sun starts to come up and the light just begins to appear, there's a richness of character and in a lot of cases, tranquility. And the shot, Mist Rising, is taken on a lake up in the Adirondacks. It's a very early morning on a lake. I call it Mist Rising because it's a sunrise shot, and normally people say sunrise, but the mist coming up off the lake and the bright colors that the little bit of sunlight that's showing draws off the water, and there's a float, swimming float out in the water, and it's just a peaceful, very early morning scene. As a landscape architect, and I do parks and open space, as I said, almost exclusively, and that's kind of a social mission for me, and I have kind of a tagline that I've carried with me for quite a while, and it says, make the world a better place every day. And I emphasize the every day because I think every day you have an opportunity to do something or say something. And so my work is kind of revolves around that. And I've got an image in the show of the playground at Caddy Park, which I designed in the late 80s when I was with the MDC. I was landscape architect for the Metropolitan District Commission, and Caddy Park is on what used to be called, or still known as Gull Island, along Quincy Shore Drive, but it's also named for Marine Corporal Caddy, who was from Quincy. And the playground is a wonderful, the color and everything fits into the wooded background so well. And a fascinating story about that project is while we were building the playground, we found an amazing stash of early Native American artifacts that, you know, used that site, and those are preserved at BU at this time. One of the things that I wanted to do for this show is I looked through my collection, some in my previous collection, some in work that I've done, and some just going around and taking some Quincy shots to bring it alive. In fact, I think one of the things that I'm going to do in the show is have a little game for the viewers to see. And I think I'll probably have 5 or 6 photos and ask people to try to identify the photos, and they can put their findings in a slip, and then I'll have a drawing at the end of the show, and you know, 1 or 2 I'll pick out, and they can come and pick a photograph that they like. And so I have a number of shots all around Quincy. Most of them you won't immediately identify as being in the city. Some might be places you know well, and maybe a new way of looking at something, or maybe there's a clue inside the photograph that helps you identify it as Quincy. And then, you know, and some people will be inspired and kind of, you know, go out around looking for where these photographs are so that they can identify them. So I think that'll be a lot of fun. But this is an opportunity, you know, for me to really put some things on display, get some feedback, share with a broader audience this art that I, for 40 years, have kind of done as a private thing for my own jollies, I guess, and now to open it up to a broader audience, and hopefully some people will find something of interest.